sun, sunshine, wind blowing, and coupons. Do you clip?
No, actually my stylist does the clipping for me. Trevante.
Oh, honey, I was talking about the coupons.
Oh, how quaint.
Excuse me, my good friend Kevin. Is that a toy plane you're playing with?
It is. It's actually the 2012 model with the retractable hood.
Ah, I see. Santa must love you more this year than me.
Oh, certainly, you jest.
So what school does your kid go to?
Dawson Elementary. He's in Mr. Burton's class.
Mr. LeVar Burton's class? Oh, I just love him. You know what I love about him? The way he incorporates such a wide spectrum of colorful stories.
Well, my friend Tiffany recommended it to me. She works with the school board, and she always knows what's best for my school.
Really? We were just zoned through there.
I'm sorry, who's me?
Oh, my son and I. The last of three. My little peanut. Do you have a nickname for your kid?
Stuart. Stuart Jebediah Carmichael the second.
Wow. That's something?
His father named him, actually.
Oh, really? Tell me a story. I just love stories like that. You know, Bob picked me up at a McDonald's.
We met in grad school. We're both accountants.
Oh, let me see the ring.
I actually don't wear it on work days. It's a bit heavy.
Oh, I can't imagine leaving any place without it. I never take it off.
I like to let our love speak for itself.
Can't imagine doing that. Just feels disrespectful.
My friend, you must try these scrumptious things that I found in the ground earlier.
Does it taste similar to Chef Boyardee?
Oh, no. It isn't anything like we ever had before. You're simply a delight. A delight.
Well, now I'm intrigued. But hold that thought. Mother? 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 All the asses, ugh. But anyway, so tell me about this one.
Rip my hair out and just give up because of that little shit.
I just feel like, I try to imagine what would happen if I started over, you know? Started fresh. Am I crazy? Am I the only one?
I've got to tell you. Okay. So, there we were. I was strolling down the street with my mother, and then all of a sudden I see this man that's at least 13 feet tall. And so, I mean, he has the baldest and shiniest head. Of course I see it, and I have to remark about it, of course. And so I look at him and I say, "Sir, don't you know that your head is bald?"
And what was his response, good man?
Damnation! Every single time! I mean, how does I think this is plan of saying this is if their supply is always depleted?
I'm a bit peckish. Should we go see our parental advisors?
Indubitably.
Come here, sweetie, come here. Are you playing nice?
Yeah. Okay. This is my friend Kevin.
And this is Stewie.
Are you hungry?
Hey!
Okay.
Oh,
I'm looking for
So, tell me, my good fellow, are you courting the beautiful goddess that is Isabella?
No, what? Oh no, we have a strictly platonic relationship. merely friends.
Really? So, not even the occasional romantic juice behind the oak tree? Anyway, I have a thought. I have to say, I've seen Isabel share a lollipop or two with some of the other children. But she's no good for you.
My God, you rapscallion. I love you, girl.
Is this enough? Is she worthy of yourself?
years. I mean, it's enough for my parents.
I'm not so sure about that. I tend to doubt as much for my parents.
He is such a nice man. He really seems to complete you.
Well, Kurt, it does get a bit frustrating at times, but he does always have my back, and when he needs, I have his. But I don't think relationships are about one completing the other. It's two wholes coming together to create a family.
My first anniversary with Bob. He had pink flowers everywhere. He always buys me flowers. And even when times get hard, I always wake up to a pot of coffee brewing for me. After all this time, he still remembers my addiction.
I should hope your husband will always remember mine.
So, in the end, have you found that it's all worth it?
I suppose it is. And I believe it is for us too.
Mayhaps you're right. I guess I must have had my knickers in a twist for quite some time about girls. But to be fair, there's just something so damnably gross.
Is that something you're worried about? You'll forget it?
I don't know. Maybe. Sometimes. Love is different now.
That happens.
Love is harder now. Work now. At this rate, I feel like I have two jobs, or I'll have two jobs. Even three, including him.
That won't happen. Or it shouldn't. And from what I just saw from the two of you, I promise it won't. You know, I've only just met you, and but I know about these things. Yes, Bob is pissed about the recession. Yes, I doubt our relationship sometimes. When your husband went out of his way to see, just to see you for 2 seconds and give you flowers, of course I was jealous. But that's my own fault. Deborah, life is difficult. It, Lord knows relationships are. Having kids is exhausting. It's exasperating and frustrating and hilarious and completely and utterly rewarding. And I know that it's all worth it when I can wake up every morning and I choose to love my husband unconditionally. And I can say that and I can remember. I can remember that even when my kid is being a freaking little shit.
Thank you. So, sure.
You know, I believe so. Because even though our love, me and Isabella, isn't as strong as my parents, I can't let that affect how I feel about it.
Well, my brother, I give you my blessing. If you want to pursue Isabel, then feel free to. Who am I to say that you can't?